यस। सो व्हाट हैपेंड इज व्हेन अ चाइल्ड हैज़ अ बैड लाइफ, यू नो वी मस्ट नो व्हाई ही हैड दिस लाइफ, यू नो गेटिंग हिमसेल्फ सो मच पैथेटिक। यू नो ही डिडंट हैव हिज फैमिली टुगेदर, ही डिडंट हैव हिज मदर विथ हिम, ही वाज सेंट टू बोर्डिंग स्कूल, बट ही वेंट थ्रू दिस टफ थिंग। यू नो व्हेन आई वाज आल्सो इन बोर्डिंग इन 84, 85, 86, 84, 85, 86, when I had joined the boarding school, so there was punishment there also. It heavily, heavily punished. You know, the college captain used to punish him. There was no looking into it, but gradually the Supreme Court has brought down. There's no corporal punishment. There's no physical punishment. So you guys are lucky. So we have gone through that part, and that's why we have become so trained this much these days. We think we are the boss these days. So that's why you know you learn less, but. Corporal punishment was there in my time also. In the military also, when I was in the paramilitary, there was corporal punishments were there. You know, we used to call it fatigues, and it was really very bad. But it has trained us. Today I am whatever I am. I'm whatever mistakes I have done. I have had punishments. I have grown up. I have seen. I know about it. So that's how I go ahead. So in this part, we see that in 1867. What happened is in 1876, sorry, in 1876, graduating at the age of 17, Arthur Doyle, he was also called, as he was called before adding his middle name Conan to his surname, was a surprisingly young, normal man. With his innate sense of humor and his sportsmanship, having ruled out any feelings of self-pity, Arthur was ready and willing to face the world. Oh, that good-looking fellow, a smart chap, having that sportsmanship inside him, and you know that sense of humor, used to have that kind of, used to not feel bad for himself. He used to not, he used to make people laugh. He used to keep them on their toes, you know, with his stories and all. Years later, he wrote, "Perhaps it was good for me that the times were hard, for I was wild, full-blooded, and a trifle reckless. But the situation called for energy and application, so that one was bound to try to meet it. My mother had been so splendid that I could not fail her. It had been said that Arthur's first task when he was back from school was to co-sign the committal papers of his father, who by then was seriously demented. One can get a fairly good idea of the dramatic circumstances which surrounded the confinement of his father to a lunatic asylum. He was declared mad. He was sent to a mad hospital. In a story Arthur Doyle wrote also in 1880 called The Surgeon of Casterfell. Family tradition would have dictated the pursuit of an artistic career, yet Arthur decided to follow a medical one. This decision was influenced by Dr. Brian Charles Waller, a young lodger his mother had taken in to make ends meet. Dr. Waller had trained at University of Edinburgh, and that is where Arthur was sent to carry out his medical studies. Now, when his father was, you know, because of this alcoholic thing and all, you know, he came back from school and he had to sign papers, you know, was to co-sign the committal papers of his father, who had been seriously demented. Now, demented in the scene, if I want to explain you, I have to explain it in a very easy way. Demented is when people get that anger type of thing, you know, always in a two brain functions happening inside your head. Forgetfulness, limited social skills, thinking abilities go off. You know, with daily functioning, your things go wrong. You try to become mad, you know, that's because you are drinking too much. Okay. you are sent to a rehabilitation center. That happens with drugs and alcohol. So alcoholism and drugism is very bad. So he had to come and sign papers that, yes, my father is like this. He had to co-sign committal papers. And he had written about the circumstances which surrounded his father's confinement. You know, you're put into an asylum, lunatic, mad type of asylum, the surgeon of Castelfel. So during that time, his mother had taken in a paying guest, a young person. His name was Dr. Waller, Dr. Brian Charles Waller, to have some extra money, you know, by giving it on rent, you know, paying guest, you know, we'll get some men to meet the ends of the family. Dr. Waller had trained at University of Edinburgh, and that is where Arthur was sent to carry out his medical studies. The young medical student met a number of future authors, you know, who were also attending the university, including James Barry, Robert Louis Stevenson. And however, the man who most impressed and influenced him was, without doubt, one of his teachers, Dr. Joseph Bell. The good doctor was a master at observation, logic, deduction, and diagnosis. All these qualities were later to be found in the persona of the celebrated detective Sherlock Holmes. A couple of years into his studies, Arthur decided to try his pen at writing a short story. The mystery entitled of the Sasasa Valley. The mystery of Sasasa Valley was a very evocative of the works of Edgar Allan Poe and Bret Harte, his favorite authors at that time. It was accepted in Edinburgh magazine called Chambers Journal, which had published Tom Hardy's first work. Same year, Conan Doyle's second story comes out, The American Tale, which was published in London Society, making him write much later. It was in this year that I first learned that shillings might be earned in other ways than by filling files. Files are doctor, medicine files we have. In filling files, you know, you make medicines. He has gone to become to study medicines. He said, I can earn money, not only filling medicine or making medicine, I can earn by writing also. That's what he said. It was in this year that I first learned that shillings might be earned in other ways than by filling files. So we'll keep it till here. And it's quite a long story about him. We have to know actually why he made Sherlock Holmes. So, and we'll come back after that, the next part, okay? And I'll do it with you. So till then, take care, be good, and read. Don't read now, just go on to something and try to understand what is this all about. A father, a son who had his father like this drinking, and what will happen to his family. Mother was very educated and she helped him, and he had to keep up his mother's promise, so he said he'll not do anything wrong. He went through the torture and he came out as a prince. You know, a horse, a wild horse. My father used to call me a black horse. I was not tamed by anyone. I used to not listen to anyone except my father. I used to not listen to my mother also. My father only I used to listen. I was scared of my mother, but I used to not listen to her. And even after my mother and father passed away, the last person who I was working for, he also used to call me a black horse. I used to not feel scared of anyone except him, because he understood me very well. So he used to tame me. He used to say it like this: I have your reins in my hand. Whichever side I tell you to go, you go. So I'm that one man dog type of thing. You know, I don't get tamed with anyone. So I'm very wild type of thing. So if I like anyone, I'll do anything for that person. But if I don't like that person, I'll not look back. So it's like that. I was sent to the hostel. I have been to the military also with my wish. You know, I've got trained. I know, I have seen a lot of bad things in life, lot of harmful things in life, and which makes you more stronger. I wanted to do everything. I have done everything. Maybe I don't have a box of certificates. Maybe I am not a doctor, I am not an engineer, I am not a pilot, I am not, but I know basic things. But if I drive a car, if a car gets stuck on the road, I know how to reach home safely, which many people don't know to do. Okay, so it's like that. So we'll come back in the next class, we'll talk about it and let you know more about it. We'll ask you also, what is your story, what is your past and all. So we come to know what you want to do in life, what are you planning. So till then, take care and bye-bye, God bless.